In the last few sessions of this video lecture, I have discussed how to perform qualitative tests such as direct smear, sedimentation, and flotation test. You know, in qualitative test, only the presence or absence of egg of helminths and cyst and oocyst protozoa are known. In quantitative test, it is possible to count the eggs, cyst, and oocyst. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss the modified McMaster test. The purpose of all the qualitative tests are to count the eggs, cysts, and oocysts so that the degree of infection or intensity of infection can be assumed. It also helps to estimate the extent of parasite egg contamination on the pasture grazed by an infected animal. This will further help to determine the efficacy of the drug treatment, that is, if you want to assess an anthelmintic resistance on certain parasites based on the techniques called fecal egg count reduction test, you have to perform a qualitative test. There are few tests available as qualitative tests. They are modified McMaster test, modified stool test, and Cornell Wisconsin egg counting test. The easiest qualitative test is the modified McMaster test. This test requires a special reusable slide and it can be purchased from different suppliers of the world. Along with the McMaster slide, saturated salt solution is required as flotation fluid to perform the test. The procedure of this test is pretty simple. This test can be done with centrifugation or without centrifugation of a sample. First, I will discuss how will you perform the test without centrifugation of a sample. First dilute 3 grams of feces in 42 ml of flotation fluid, or you may take 4 grams in 56 ml or 2 grams in 28 ml of flotation fluid, that is 1:15 ratio. Mix well and strain the fecal suspension using a tree strainer. Then immediately fill each of the chamber of the McMaster slide using a posterior pipette or just a syringe. Remember, fill the entire chamber, not the area under the grid. If large air bubbles are there, remove the fluid and refill. Then allow the slide to sit for 5 minutes so that eggs can float. Examine the slide at 10x objectives of the microscope. Count the eggs or the stages of the parasite in each lane of the chamber of the McMaster slide. Each type of eggs, cyst or oocyst should be counted separately. Now I will explain how will you perform the modified McMaster test with centrifugation of a sample. First, dilute the sample in the mentioned ratio in water instead of flotation fluid. Filter it using a tree strainer, then take 15 ml of fecal suspension in a Falcon tube and centrifuge it at 1500 RPM for 3 to 5 minutes. Discard the supernatant and add flotation fluid up to 15 ml mark of the tube and mix it properly. Fill both chamber of the McMaster slide, allow 3 to 5 minutes to float the stages of the parasite and examine the both chambers to count the eggs of the parasites. Now I will talk about the calculation. The expression unit of this egg counting techniques is egg per gram of feces or cyst per gram of feces or oocyst per gram of feces. You know, there are two chambers of the McMaster slide. The volume of each chamber is 0.15 ml. So the volume of both chamber would be 0.30 ml. For the first procedure that I discussed was without centrifugation of a sample. Remember, in that case, 3 grams of feces sample are diluted in 42 ml of flotation fluid. So 1 gram feces will remain in 15 ml fluid, and you counted the eggs in just 0.5 ml of the fluid in case of one chamber of the McMaster slide. So 0.15 ml is the 100th of 15 ml. Similarly, 0.30 ml of fluid is the 50th of 15 ml. So multiply the number of eggs, cysts, oocysts by 100 for one chamber. For both chambers, the dilution factor would be 50. In the second scenario, in case of the test performing with centrifugation, the sample was already in 15 ml, where 1 gram feces was diluted. So the dilution factor would be the same, that is 100 if you consider one chamber and 50 if you consider counting the egg cyst and oocyst of both chambers. Let's say you counted only 15 eggs in both chambers. What would be the egg per gram of feces? Write it in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this video. Watch the next video lecture on fecal culture and Behrmann test.